Hey, and welcome to the next part of our mini-series using Hikvision's new Android indoor screen. Okay then, so as you see, this is our setup we have here. We have our door station, doorbell connected to our switch, which is like the hub, and that's connected to our internet and connected to our indoor screen. Okay, it's all hardwired using Ethernet cable, nothing special about that, but we will be configuring our system using iVMS-4200 today. Okay, so for those of you a bit unfamiliar with it, I've left a link below how to use it, how to set it up. But what I advise is check out some other videos where we use it. And if you are going to get into intercom, I highly recommend you get familiar with iVMS. Okay, so this is our little setup. I'm going to quickly show you the items we're using. So this is our indoor monitor screen. It has HitConnect built in, so you can have all the Hikvision devices added here. And you can add up to two Android apps as well. Okay, obviously it works as an intercom screen as well. Someone rings the doorbell, the screen's going to ring. Okay, this is our outdoor station doorbell. Okay, there's different ones on the market and they all basically work the same. So you can, whatever which one you have, it'll be the same configuration as I'm going to be doing today. Okay, and this is our switch, which as I said before, kind of acts like a main hub where everything goes through here. Okay, you connect this to your outdoor station, your indoor station and the internet. Okay, so we're going to go flip over now to iVMS-4200 and I'm going to show you how to set it up. Okay, so if you've seen our previous videos, I recommend checking them out. You're going to see the actual physical setup. I'm not going to show you on this video, but everything is all hardwired right next to me. And let's go ahead and configure it. So all these items that you see are active. These means these are existing devices on our network. But what we're looking at today is the two inactive devices. So inactive means basically brand new out the box. Okay, so this is our indoor screen and this is our outdoor door station. So we click on here and we're going to go activate. Okay, so we put in a password. We will only be using one password for the whole setup. So anytime I say put in a password, it'll be this one. So try not to forget it. And then we're going to go ahead and enable DHCP. So as you see, this is our IP address right now, 192.0.0.65. We're going to go ahead and enable DHCP. And then it should give us a local IP. Okay. Okay, so our IP now is 1044148. Perfect. So we go add that device and we call this one door station. Okay. We add it. Okay, so it's online, that means it's found it. Door station's added. So now we do the same thing to our indoor screen. So we activate it. Okay. Then we enable DHCP. Okay, and we go ahead and add that device. So we call this the indoor screen. Okay, so we're going to go ahead up and set up the door station first of all, but I'm going to quickly log onto the screen and show you some parameters that we're going to need. Okay, so to add the screen to the door station, you're going to need this bit of information here. So take a note of the local IP address, subnet mask, gateway and port number. And you're also going to need your serial number for your panel. Okay, so we're going to need to enter all these details. So we go to our door station here, top one, and we click on remote configuration. And now we're going to add on the panel. Okay, so we go down to device management and we go add. Okay. So put in a password. Okay, you're gonna need the serial number, which I copied and pasted earlier. IP address, which you can get from up here. So the indoor screen IP address is 1044147. Okay, subnet mask from before. And the IP default gateway. Okay then. And port is fine, floor number is not. And number one, we just put number one because it's going to be the only screen. We go okay. Okay, so it's added it, which is good. But as you see, it's offline. Okay, that's normal. We're going to go get that online now. So we can close this panel and we go log into our indoor screen. We go to network and at the bottom, group network settings. And up here, as you see, it's found the main door station, the IP 148. Okay, it already knows it's there. So he's gonna give it a password now. Okay, go save. Saved at the bottom, perfect. Okay, it should all be configured now. We'll double check, go back to the door station, and it should say online. So device management, online, perfect. So I've got the station next to me, let's give it a quick buzz, and then see if it works. Yeah, perfect, first time. So that's how you configure Android screen using iVMS-4200. Cheers, and check out our other videos we have coming up. We're going to show you how to add apps and use HitConnect and a few other bits and pieces. So I'll see you then, and thanks for watching. Cheers, bye.